All right, so then
out of state gas corporation can get rich while the poor go to hell. They say they believe in democracy, but they're making it harder to vote and detaining our immigrant workers. They think freedom is some kind of joke. Dragging us back to the bad old days. The poor had no voice. Now we're making the choice to stand up and sing out today. Arrest us and throw us in prison if that's what it takes to be heard. But you can't keep us quiet forever. The people will have the last word. Dragged back to the bad old days. We will remember when we vote next November. So join us and speak out today.
And every one of them has now got a file at the State Bureau of Investigation. I love that.
We say no to voter ID.
We shall not be moved.
Say
no to voter ID. We shall not be moved.
Just like a tree that's being moved.
Yeah. Look, they get scared and run away. The girl's running away. It's okay. We're all on camera. It's okay. Yeah. Oh, beautiful. It just landed on the American flag right above the protest. Awesome. Look at that beautiful animal. Oh.
Is that an immature eagle?
It's a hawk. It's a hawk. It's a big, I don't think it's too big to be a hawk. I think it's a pretty big hawk.
Yeah, it's so far away. What do you see?
It's a hawk.
Wow.
Oh, there's a hawk on the flagpole.
Not American eagle.
Oh, wow.
What does the hawk think about fracking?
They've got a nest over there.
Oh, do they really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's
across
awesome.
The street.
Oh, fracking!
Get out! They're gonna live on this. Turn it around. Gonna keep on walking. Keep on talking. Marching on the freedom land.
They're gonna let nobody.
Working who have lost their jobs, no fault of their own, denied unemployment on July 1st. That's bad for everyday people. That's bad for North Carolina. That's bad for America. 900,000 people who will lose their earned income tax so that somebody can give 23 millionaires a tax cut. That's bad for everyday people. That's bad for North Carolina. That's bad for America.
That's right.
Rolling back the Racial Justice Act when you know that race is a part of our judicial system. That's bad for everyday people. That's bad for North Carolina. That's bad for America. When we see what's going on, the tax on the environment, cutting last year $1.6 billion from public education, and now denying poor children preschool. They're talking about taking tax dollars and putting it in a private school through vouchers.
Yes.
That's
yes.
bad for everyday
yes.
people.
Yes.
That's bad for North Carolina.
Yes.
And that's bad for America.
Yes.
That's right.
And then on top of that, when you know that you've done all these bad things and regressive things and immoral and unconstitutional things, then you think, well, maybe the people might wake up in 2 years. And so since I've done this, now I've got to restrict the right to vote.
Yep.
So I want to rig the election because I know that my narrow-minded agenda doesn't stand a chance in the New South and in the New North Carolina.
Yes.
And when you know that there's a new coalition out here, 25% of the electorate is African American.
Yep.
When you add that to Latinos and to progressive whites and to labor and to faith, you know that the solid South is cracking.
Yep.
That the wall is coming down.
Yep.
That those of us that are the sons and daughters of a movement past and a new movement now are pushing forward into a brand new South. And so when you don't want that, you start rigging the election.
Yep.
Yep.
You start it with redistricting.
Yep.
But we might beat you on that. So then you say you want voter ID. We haven't needed it for 237 years. Uh-huh. It's a solution in search of a problem.
Yep.
A costly solution. We know that it's poll tax, 21st century poll tax. We know it's wrong. But then you say you're going to further that. When you pass it, you're going to make it more restrictive than South Carolina and Alabama. You're going to restrict students from private schools. Then you're going to have a bill out there that says you got to, that if somebody wants to test your mental competency before you vote, you're going to make felons that pay their time, wait 5 years, and then they have to apply to a 3-member local election board to get their rights back that are guaranteed by the 15th Amendment. Then on top of that, you're going to say students go to college, they live in, their family lives in Plymouth, and they go to school in Chapel Hill, their parents have to pay $2,500 for them to vote where they go to school. And the name of the title of that bill is what, Bob? Where's Bob?
666.
Say it again, Bob.
666.
We didn't write that. We didn't write that. That popped out of the computer. That just popped out of the computer.
Senate Bill 666.
Senate Bill 666.
Mark of the Beast.
Right.
So somebody asked me, they said, well, are the people in there evil? I said, that God looks at that, but what I look at is the fruit. He said a tree is known by the fruit. And the fruit of these policies are mean, evil spirited, regressive, unnecessary, uncivil, and unconstitutional.
Yes.
Now their rules say you can't pray in the legislature. Their rules say you can't have a teacher, and their rules say you can't hold a placard. And even though the Constitution says we have a right to instruct our legislators.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
So people are coming today who are willing to break that rule because we believe they are violating a greater rule.
Yes.
They're violating the Constitution. The only way they should be using their power is for the good of the whole. They're using it for the whims of a few. That's a violation of our most fundamental rights.
Yep.
So when others come, they'll be here in a minute. We want to support them. If you're not doing civil disobedience today, go in, be supportive of them. Be mindful if there's anybody here that wants to start something, because some guy, I don't know his name, tried to suggest, you know, we were doing something so mean and wrong, but don't respond to anybody who may say something negative to you. We know where our attention is. Our attention is on the Speaker of the House and the people he leads, the Senate pro tem, the leader he leads, and the governor. They don't have to do this. They could roll back the cut to unemployment before July 1st. They could change their mind on the Medicaid before December 31st. The governor could say, I don't want to be known as the George Wallace of the 21st century. And so he could say, I'm not going to sign these crazy voting laws. They might still pass with the supermajority, but he would be on the right side of history. And then we would take them to court, as we're going to do anyway. So we hope they change. We love them, but we don't like their policy. But if they don't change, while we're doing the legal strategy, while we're organizing the vote for 2014, we do civil disobedience to ensure that the most powerful moral light possible can be shown on what they're doing to guarantee that nobody in this state, this country, or this world does not know how they are trying to go backwards while we, the people, want to go forward.
I loved when I took some pictures of the folks up on the building there. They ducked their heads down, these girls and these young pages, and they're like, come on, man, you're already, you know you're on camera.
We're all on camera.
Uh-huh. They won?
Somebody.
with arms stretched out. We ask your blessing now, God, on these that go forward to be advocates for justice. We give you thanks that they're going to step forward and bear witness that we are not here to see Medicaid denied.
That's right.
We're not here to see voter suppression.
That's right.
We're not here to see earned income tax credits taken away.
That's right.
We're not here to see people trampled. So we ask your blessing now and your power and your spirit to go with those who go in to advocate for justice. And now be with all of us that we may continue to bear witness to the justice that you call us to. This we ask in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
I know.
Whoa! down upon the crown.
All right. I only have a minute. Ed, how much time do I have? Hey, I had to do all this myself, but seriously, those protests, that protest Monday night at the legislature was incredible. It was just, you know, it's just ordinary people looking stupid sometimes, being really open and doing what they do, but they're doing something. You can't just sit and do nothing while these people are driving North Carolina into the ground. It's really important to keep in mind that the North Carolina Republicans and House and Senate Republicans are running the legislature exactly the same way Jim Black ran the state legislature when Jim Black was accepting cash underneath men's room bathroom stalls. They're doing it exactly the same way. If you go to my Twitter feed, twitter.com/TMORMAN. Ed, how much time I got? Ed? Just yell out how much time I got. I'm on my own here. 2 minutes. Okay, thanks, Ed. I'm running back and forth. But if you go to my Twitter page, there's a couple of really interesting links. The Senate Finance Committee pulled back the renewable energy law that was passed in North Carolina in 2007 with Duke and Progress's on a voice vote. But WRAL, and I'm telling you, WRAL's been covering this legislature sharply. I will no longer diss TV news. I don't have cable, so I can't watch this show or WRAL. I have a TV that's only a VCR monitor, you know, or DVD monitor. But anyway, WRAL's online coverage of the legislature has been fantastic. They're doing really, it's not as sharp as it could be, but it's pretty damn sharp. And they went out and dug up the actual votes of the people in the room when the head of the Finance Committee just called for a voice vote and said, okay, the repeal passes out of committee. And WRAL actually went, aye, nay, okay, it passes. Clearly the nays for the repeal of the Renewable Energy Act that encourages North Carolina to move into the future. And don't give me this ideologically driven crap that the free market they all have to stand on their own on the free market. Coal, nuclear, all of them, they do not stand on their own in the free market. They don't. So don't give me that crap. Oh, suddenly when wind and solar are involved, suddenly we have to go ahead and, they have to stand alone in the free market on their own two legs with no subsidies. But none of the other established energy industries have to do that. Anyway, long story short, WRAL went back and counted the votes and those yays and those nays. It turns out the repeal of the Renewable Energy Act from 2007 did not pass that committee, but the head, what's the guy's name? I forget his name. Oh, we'll have to talk next week about his name. I've got it back there, but I can't run back. The head just shoved it through. Refused to let anybody count. It's actually against the law to do a head count. An actual, count of votes in North Carolina in the Senate. Anyway, I got to wrap it up. All right. Anyway, long story short, the repeal of the Renewable Energy Act did not pass out of committee. It did not. The votes denied it. But the head of that committee, the Republican head of that committee, passed it anyway. They're doing exactly what Jim Black did. Exactly. When Jim Black was accepting paper bags full of cash underneath a men's room stall, that's exactly the way that the Republicans are now running the legislature after all their promises.